God. Say, when I'm afraid, I will trust in you. When I'm afraid. You see, when I'm afraid, I know where to run to. I run into his presence. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? David said, I shall not be afraid of 10,000s of people that come against me. Amen. That is, you look at the devil and say, go and gather 10,000 of you together and come. I will not be afraid of you. Because I dwell in the secret place of the Most High, whose power no foe can withstand. Are you tracking with me? Psalm 42, as the deer pants for the water brooks, so pants my soul for you, O God. Verse 2, my soul thirsts for God. There are going to be people who will be hungry for his presence. My soul thirsts for you, O God, for the living God, for God, for the living God. When shall I come and appear before God? Thank God we are in his presence. He said, I will never leave you nor forsake you. My tears have been my food day and night, while they continually say to me, where is your God? I want to say to you today that there are many things around us asking us that question, where is your God? You know, as Pastor Kola was leading prayer tonight, I had to be praying. You know what I was, one of the things I was praying at the point was that, God, I Lord, please, every spirit of this land that I've received, I reject it. You know, because when you begin to come to a place where you are more conscious of your environment than you are of God, you need to spend time in the presence of God to expunge some things. Why is it that is when people come from outside, they see what is wrong with you and you don't know? But as they spend more time there, they take on the spirit of the land. And you begin to lose your cutting edge. You know, it's very easy for any person who comes to your house to see what is wrong. But you've been living there, sleeping and waking up. Is that not true? We need to understand that we are citizens of heaven. We are on a pilgrimage. We are going through. We are passing through. We must make sure we don't take on spirits. Are you following what I'm saying? Because it's very easy for us to become complacent. For us to begin to think like ordinary people would think. Amen. Oh, it is whatever today. Then, it is that. Then, I'm not saying go and do some crazy stuff you shouldn't do. But you know what I'm saying. Is that not true? If you spent a long time, for instance, around some people, you will stop being a giver. Let me break it down. Somebody say, break it down. Break it down. I don't like talking in the air. Break it down. If you stay around people who are penny pinchers, I'm not saying you should not budget. And I'm not saying you should not have accountability. And I'm not saying you should not be frugal. But there are some people. And it's a spirit in the land. You know what somebody actually said? She came here to do her master's in Cambridge. She's of, I don't want to mention how connected she is to me for security reasons. Amen. She came to this country just to do her master's in Cambridge. Such a brilliant girl. She's a, you know, first class student, came from Nigeria, did her whatever in Cambridge. And then she said, at first she was thinking of staying behind. She said, I'm going back. So if I stay long in this country, I won't give anybody anything. But when she dissected what 20 pounds was to me, the hours of labor that is, I'm like, excuse me. She said, I will not be able to give anything to anybody. Not because money will not come, but she will be so conscious. 20 pounds means 2 hours of work. How can you just give away 2 hours of work? Someone says, spirit of the land. I'm breaking it down. After, I'm not mentioning your name. But he that hath an ear. God wants to meet your needs according to his riches in glory by Christ Jesus. I don't want to be old and be counting pennies. Amen. I don't want to. That's not my plan. I'm not planning for that. Do you understand? Okay, thanks for the thunderous silence. Another spirit of the land. When they say, let us pray, it's as if they announce that somebody died. Even I've seen people make more noise when somebody died than when they say, let's pray. Can someone say prayer is the key? Jesus started with prayer. He ended with prayer. Another spirit of the land, when they say, let's fast, before it's 10 a.m., is it 10 or 2? Are you hearing what I'm saying? Some things don't match. Spirituality does not go with some things. Do you understand now? Should I go on? Okay. So do you want to now expunge from your system the spirit? You know, the Bible talks about the spirit of this age, the spirit of this world. There are some spirits that unconsciously we take on and we take in. And we need to constantly come to the presence of God. Do you know another spirit that is in this land? The spirit of unbelief. Though I see it, I will not believe it. Amen. Oh, I know this pain has gone, but I think it's just a coincidence. Oh, I know the pain has gone, but I'm sure it will come back again. Unbelief. Unbelief. The Bible says, let us be careful. We should not take on the spirit of what? Unbelief. When someone says, God said this to me, hey, brother, just be careful. Just be careful. I remember I thank God I was not in this country when God told me to give my whole dressing allowance they gave us into a particular ministry. Some would have said, are you sure? I want you to know that God will not ask of you what he has not already done. And God will not ask you to do what he is already to do. Amen. If God is asking you to give your all, it's because he's already given his all and he's always willing to give his all. Are you following me? Can someone say God is good? Now let's begin a roundup. Are you glad you came? I could give you more examples. You see, if we didn't give such examples, you just say, yes, spirit of the land, you know. It's not like that. You can identify it. It is identifiable. So when you find yourself taking on those spirits, lock yourself in your room and say, I'm a citizen of heaven. I'm not of this world. Amen. I am not of this world. That is when reading the Bible will mean something to you, not just a religious exercise. Because now you are studying the Bible to take on the thoughts of God, the ways of God, the attributes of God, to do things the way he did things. Let this mind be in you, the same mind that was in Christ Jesus. You are embracing his mind, his attitude, his mindset, his disposition. Is that okay? He says, while they say, continually say to me, where is your God? There are many things around you asking you, where is your God? Do you know it's not up to God? It is up to you. To demonstrate your God is well and alive. It is not up to God. He said, my tears have been my meat all day long. You must hunger for God. You must thirst for his presence. When shall I appear before you? You must long to be in his presence, to dwell in his presence. To walk in his presence, we must learn to generate his presence. He already said, lo, I'm with you always, even to the end of the age. Matthew 19:20. Hebrews 13:5. For he himself has said, I will never leave you nor forsake you. As I was thinking about it, the little knowledge I gained when I used to do physics before I, you know, there was this joke in our house. You know, we're trying to speak some French, you know, because our baby, you know, one of the courses she's doing in